Imagine a world where time travel is possible. You dial back to the 1960s, a golden era of jazz. The door opens, and the first sound you hear is the mesmerizing tenor of Wayne Shorter from his iconic album Adam's Apple. Welcome to a journey through a pivotal moment in jazz history, and today we are going to take a deep dive into this classic album. So grab some tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy our video. But before you do this, please hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell. Thanks. Recorded on February 3rd and 24th, 1966, in the legendary Van Gelder studio in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey, Adam's Apple captures a time when jazz was not just music but a revolution, and Rudy Van Gelder, the master engineer, worked his magic. Born on August 25th, 1933, in Newark, New Jersey, Wayne Shorter grew up immersed in music. He pursued music education at New York University, honing his skills and deepening his jazz knowledge. Before Adam's Apple, Shorter had already made a name for himself with Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers and the Miles Davis Quintet. His contributions to these groups were significant, shaping the direction of jazz fusion. Now fast forward to the present, and this classic album was reborn in 2019 with the Music Matters Jazz Blue Note, the definitive vinyl reissue SRX series. Mastered from the original analog tapes by Kevin Gray and pressed on 180-gram vinyl, this reissue is a treasure for audiophiles. Kevin Gray's mastering of the reissue is nothing short of remarkable, bringing new life to this classic album. The clarity of the pressing is evident, with each instrument distinctly separated, allowing for an incredible listening experience. SRX, standing for Silent Running Experience, is a revolutionary vinyl formula developed by Rick Hashimoto of Record Technology and manufactured by Neotech. Its low noise floor significantly enhances the listening experience, making it nearly free from any groove noise, offering a more authentic and immersive listening experience for any serious audiophile. Now for the music. The title track, Adam's Apple, is a vibrant showcase of Shorter's compositional prowess and improvisational skill. His tenor takes the lead, weaving through the complex rhythms with ease. Herbie Hancock's piano provides a harmonious backdrop, while Reggie Workman's bass and Joe Chambers' drums create a solid rhythmic foundation. The track is a perfect blend of blues influences and modern jazz, highlighting the talents of each musician. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Up next, we have the track Footprints, which stands out as a classic, with its distinctive 6/8 time signature and memorable melody. Shorter's tenor leads the way, exploring the song's intricate structure with skillful improvisation. Hancock's piano complements Shorter's lines, adding depth and texture. Workman and Chambers provide a rhythmic complexity that elevates the track, making it a quintessential example of post-bop jazz. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Thank you. Next, we have the tune El Gaucho, which is a testament to the group's cohesive interplay, featuring a bossa nova influence with unexpected chord changes. Shorter's tenor navigates these changes masterfully, while Hancock's piano accents the rhythm with flair. Workman's bass lines add a grounding element, and Chambers' drumming, especially his eighth note figures, brings a unique energy to the track. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Now for the musicians. Herbie Hancock, a pivotal figure in modern jazz, brought his exceptional piano skills to Adam's Apple. His history includes groundbreaking work with the Miles Davis Quintet and his own successful solo projects. On this album, Hancock's piano playing is both supportive and exploratory, providing a perfect counterpoint to Shorter's tenor. His contributions are integral to the album's success, showcasing his versatility and deep understanding of jazz. Reggie Workman, known for his work with John Coltrane and Art Blakey, brought his versatile bass playing to the album. His lines are both rhythmic and melodic, providing a solid foundation for the group. Workman's ability to adapt to different styles is evident throughout the album, particularly in his interplay with Hancock and Chambers. His contribution to Adam's Apple is a testament to his status as a respected and skilled bassist in the jazz world. Joe Chambers, an emerging talent at the time, showcased his drumming prowess on Adam's Apple. His previous collaborations with artists like Freddie Hubbard set the stage for his work on this album. Chambers' drumming is both sensitive and dynamic, adding a unique texture to each track. His understanding of rhythm and ability to enhance the group's sound make his contribution to the album noteworthy. Adam's Apple remains an inspiring work in Wayne Shorter's discography and in the history of jazz. Its innovative approach to composition and improvisation has influenced generations of musicians. Today, the album is celebrated for its artistic depth and the skill of its performers. This reissue has allowed new audiences to experience the magic of this classic album, ensuring its legacy continues to inspire. I want to thank you for taking this deep dive into Wayne Shorter's iconic album Adam's Apple. But before you go, please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and ring that notification bell to stay current in the jazz vinyl world. Let's keep the legacy alive, one record at a time. Bye for now. If you are interested in more deep dives into the world of jazz vinyl, then click on this video right here, where we take you on a journey into Wayne Shorter's classic album Speak No Evil.